Hey everyone, welcome to your Medieval Lit Modern Music Mashup series. On behalf of the Mashup Queen, MRO, I am your host, Dr. Leon, here to narrate this inauguration mashup featuring Lil Nas X's Montero, Call Me By Your Name, and the 10th century Old English poem called John the Baptist's Prayer, or better known as Descent into Hell. So let's get this short introduction of the poem out of the way first. This 10th century poem is found in the 10th century compilation called the Exeter Book, which is nestled away in the Exeter Cathedral Library in England. It is one of four surviving manuscripts from the early medieval English period. What is this poem about? In short, it is basically supposed to be a poem about the apocryphal story in which Jesus descends into hell. Sounds cool, right? Well, there's a plot twist, so get ready for the spoiler alert. The poem doesn't even get to the storming of the gates of hell. Jesus barely features in this at all. And all readers really get from this poem is John the Baptist's speech and description of Jesus coming to hell. So it's not really about the descent into hell, it's John the Baptist's prayer. Get it? So if you aren't familiar with the descent into hell, or the quote, harrowing, unquote, it's an apocryphal story. An apocryphal here means not quite true or not a confirmed story. This one in particular, the harrowing, is connected to the Easter story in which Jesus descends into hell to beat Satan's ass before he rises again on Easter Sunday. Jesus is meant to free everyone who is stuck there. Why? The early church folks hadn't quite worked out all the details about the Christian afterlife. They were like, where's Adam and Eve at, and King David, and all those other people? Did they wait for Jesus in some waiting room listening to slightly off-key elevator music, or what? So the early church thinkers had to think about all these things and iron out all these questions about the church. Eventually they developed a place called Limbo.
When the saints go limboing, when the saints go limboing, don't you wanna be in the number when the saints go.
Which is not a party game, but someplace in between heaven and hell, a waiting room of sorts, for the people who were from the Old Testament, but also those people considered, quote, good, unquote, in history. These early Christian thinkers were going through the list and like, nope, ooh, nope. Maybe. Think of it like swiping left or right to put people in limbo. So this poem, John the Baptist's Prayer, is basically a story about John and all the Old Testament saints waiting at the mouth of hell for Jesus to take them to heaven because heaven was around until Jesus came. He told a criminal that he was going to be with him in paradise, and the Christians were like, yay, heaven! Okay, so there's some interesting parallels between non-binary bodies referenced in the Old English poem, which is also a theme in Montero. So let's jump in. In the Old English John the Baptist prayer poem, we get ambiguous pronoun use in the first line. The poem starts in the middle of things in the early hours of the morning on Easter morning, where a group of women, described as him, are mourning their prince's death. These snippets are taken from MRO's book. In the early morning, the noble women began to prepare themselves for the journey. The council of men knew the prince's body had been encased in an earth house. Those desolate women wished to mourn with weeping, to bewail with lamentation, alone for a while, the death of the prince. The grave was grown chill. Some early critics found him troublesome in context with the rest of the line, owing to its usual translation as a masculine pronoun, although in this case, the subject is feminine plural, because him may simply refer to themselves, that is, the women, at the beginning of the poem. In Montero 2, there's this non-binary figure that's introduced right away. Here's where it starts to get really cool. Just like we are introduced to Montero by a narrator singing a song, the Old English poem, MRO argues in her book, is a liturgy sung by a narrator. The Old English poem is a song. Lil Nas X's song is a liturgy to all those who have denied or been denied their real selves, and this is their freedom song. John, the narrator in the poem, is singing his freedom poem as his savior is coming to free him and others trapped in hell. Then the Lord of mankind hastened to his journey. Heaven's protector would break and destroy the walls of hell. The most righteous of all kings set about to seize the fortress's multitude. He neither gave thought to helmeted warriors for the battle there, nor would he lead mailed warriors to the fortress gates. But thereupon the locks fell, the bars from those fortifications. The king proceeded in, the prince of all the people hastened forth, the multitude's glorious gift. The exiles pressed forward. For Lil Nas and others, they were trapped in a heteropatriarchal hell, but he's singing a freedom song for all those who have struggled with being queer. There is also some confusion in John the Baptist's prayer about narrators. Is it one? Two? It seems like the narrator is talking to himself. The mysterious wording, quote, "Get Johannes," unquote, suggests to some critics that John could not possibly be the speaker, so it must be Adam speaking, unless, for some reason, John was speaking in the third person about himself. Early editors understood "get" as a second-person dual pronoun. The connection is both Lil Nas and John are singing to themselves and to an audience. They come in and out of themselves to be part of the audience when necessary. So Lil Nas X is shackled. He isn't free. He needs a savior. Not knowing the savior is within him. He's trapped and calling for his freedom. And now I'm making hella illy. Never want the niggas that's in my league. I wanna fuck the ones I envy. I envy. In the Old English poem, John is trapped too. Part of this area of the poem is severely damaged, so it's hard to piece together the meaning, but essentially the enemy is keeping people in bonds, and people feel like they're in exile. Thanks be to you, our Prince, that you willed to seek us out, full of grief, because we were forced to endure in these bonds, while the enemy ensnares many a borderless exile, he is widely outlawed. So they need a savior. Lil Nas X descends into hell, in the same way Jesus descends into hell. Call me in the morning, I'll be on the way. Call me when you want, call me when you need. Call me out by your name, I'll be on the way. Call me by your name. Then the Lord of mankind hastened to his journey. Heaven's protector would break and destroy the walls of hell. The most righteous of all kings set about to seize the fortress's multitude. There are also allusions to the 14th century Italian poem Dante's Inferno here in both the descent and the narrator walking us through the story, but that's a later work. We can pick that up another time, or maybe you can do a parallel of this as a comparative video too. In the Old English poem John's Prayer, Jesus descends into hell in a spectacle too. All those locks are broken and people know they will be free. But Lil Nas gets the style points for riding a pole into hell in thigh-high boots. Keep in mind this is all a liturgy. This is a song of freedom. Lil Nas X is a savior figure for all those who have been held back, shackled, been denied who they are. The Old English poem doesn't describe the battle between Jesus and Satan. John the Baptist sings with excitement about being saved. In most apocryphal texts, Jesus defeats Satan, but not in this 10th century poem. We have that image in Lil Nas X's video, though. So in the end, the message in Montero is a most glorious message of a savior and freedom. There are loads more parallels to be discovered, even in this short poem, but you get the idea. The liturgy is for queer folk and those marginalized to be free. Lil Nas X has descended into hell and defeated Satan. His harrowing freed himself and others. That sounds like a savior to me. Anyway, pairing up Montero with this 10th century poem and others can breathe new life into old works. So friends, this is your Lil Nas X mashup with the Old English poem, John the Baptist Prayer. Stay tuned for our next mashup on the 8th century Dream of the Rood poem and Shakespeare's Sister. Take care, everyone. There's nothing I could catch it, throw smiles in his face. Romantic, talking, you don't even have to try. You're cute enough to fuck with me tonight. Looking at the table, all I see is weed and white. Baby, you living the life, but nigga, you ain't living right. Cocaine, drinking with your friends. You live in the dark, boy, I cannot pretend. On your face, don't need to see. If you ain't in the garden, you know that you can. Call me when you want, call me when you need. Call me in the morning, I'll be on the way. Call me when you want. Call me on the way, like.
dying of the kind, every kind that I seek, a diamond in the night.